Good morning all. This application in tourism sector is my topic. Just move on to the topic. This is the introductory part. According to World Travel and Tourism Council, tourism is one of the world's largest and most rapidly expanding industries. It will contribute with over 10% to global GDP. And generating employment for 200 million people every year. Technology plays a crucial role in the development and expansion of tourism industry. IT and tourism are two of the most dynamic motivators of emerging global economy. Both of the sectors provide strategic opportunities and powerful tools for economic growth, redistribution of wealth, and development of equity around the globe. This plays a vital role in tourism growth. By definition, this is a rationally organized set of computer hardware, software, geographic data, and users, which is designed to enable efficient collection, storage, organization, manipulation, analysis and display of spatial, geographic and all other information of interest to the user. Then, this and tourism. This is used in tourism sector in different ways in different countries. In general, the most common use of GIS in tourism is location analysis and related to transport and accommodation. In general, the following results can be achieved by queries in GIS design and application of determining tourism. First one is the determination of important and necessary places for tourism. Second one is historical and tourist places determination. Third one is the determination of the best suitable hotel. And fourth one is the determination of the optimum plan for sightseeing places. And the last one is the shortest distance between the selected places determination. Then we are move on to the next slide. Here we see the example of a GIS mapping site in India. In Uttarakhand, Almora district, there is a GIS cell. GIS mapping was done by this GIS cell. The cell operates with the support of the Natural Resource Data Management System and the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India and the Government of Uttarakhand. Here we see a spatial distribution map. The above image depicts the location of all the temples in the Almora district of Uttarakhand. Here we get similar types of maps for having different features such as population, geographical coordinates and location of hotels and guest houses, etc. Then we are move on to the next one. Tourist map. By definition, a tourist map is a graphical representation of an area presented on a plane in accordance with a specific mathematical rules. Such a map should include a topographic content, information about a tourist attraction of the given area and its tourist and a complementary infrastructure presented by conventional science appropriately for the scale of the map and its intended use. This is the simplest tourist map of Wayanad district published by Tourism Department, in which we have important tourist places with the pictures and also have a distance chart which will shows the distance between major places of Wayanad district like Kalpetta, Sultan Betheri and Manandavadi and major tourism attracted sites Below that we will have an entry time chart which will shows the entry time of the tourist places. Nowadays, two types of tourist maps were present. First one is the traditional maps, which is displayed by means of small projectors directly in the field, and the second one is the digital topographic maps. These meant to be displayed on electronic mobile devices. Here we see a picture of digital topographic tourist map. The peculiarity of this map is to carrying for mobile devices. It is very useful for bicycle tourists and mountain climbers, and it will provide present location of the tourist and also the shortest path of the tourism destination. It is user friendly carrying device. This one is the mobile device which will provide the digital topographic tourist map. Classification of tourist map is a Herculean task. For the need of tourists, it will be changed. Tourist maps are commonly classified for the following criteria. First one is the purpose or nature and type of tourism. Then map scale, content presentation method based on the base map, type of base map, and presented area, type of cartographic material and its editorial form. These are the most commonly used criteria for the classification of the tourist maps. Next, we are move on to the tourism planning. In the tourism industry, this is used to provide a digital map based for printed maps, digital files for internet mapping, digital files for mobile mapping, attractions map, website with interactive mapping. These are the GIS use in tourism industry. Next one is the creation of spatial database. Tourism planning requires more spatial data collecting and processing, as all locations and their interrelations should be defined and analyzed within a spatial context. Next one is, this is a pictorial representation of the procedure involved for the creation of spatial database in tourism map preparation. First one is the acquisition of graphical maps covering the region. Then it will be converted the paper map into digital map by digitizing. Then the creation of topology to establish the relationship between the map features. Finally, we will transform it into the real world coordinates. This is the simplest representation of the procedure involved for the creation of spatial database. Then we are move on to the here. We see the picture of extended layer model. As you all know, a GIS system uses layered data where each layer represented one form of spatial data, such as street layer, forest layer, a building layer, vegetation layer, etc. Here the real world is again classified into different layers. All these layers are combined into one to form an integrated layer with all the data. It performs as the tool to analyze spatial data and assist in building decision support systems for organizations. Then, application scenario. In the application scenario, a thematic mapper can be used to integrate tourist information and GIS data to build tourist maps. SVG can offer the possibility to turn layers on or off to create the representation which fits to the requirements of the users. And all the layers can be combined without a restriction to achieve the goal of the user. These are the application scenario. Here is the picture which will shows how to work in the integrated system based on the tourism sector. Here we see that there is a administration section, integrated GIS and a application section. In the administration section, in which the tourist agencies or hotel managers or other tourism department staffs provide their tourism attractions as tourism data. Tourism data, this is a GIS based data, and it will be again changed into integrated GIS data. So finally the tourist will get the precise data of the tourist site. In the side of tourism, tourist side, they were searching for better tourism place. So they were enquired into the GIS based system. Then the integrated GIS system will collect the tourism data from the administrators. Then it will process it and finally provide the better data for the tourists. Then we are move on to the next section, that is the potential benefits of tourism GIS for providing intelligent mapping, analytical capabilities, modeling and prediction, revenue generation. These are the potential benefits of tourism GIS. The present slide will shows some common applications of GIS in tourism. As you all know, GIS applications in the field of tourism goes back several years. Tourists can now rely on maps and other GIS related material to find their way around the world. Below are the some applications of the GIS in tourism. First one is the personality atlas. Second one is tourist map. Third one is the sunrise and sunset. Fourth one is subway mapping. Then travel mode detection, finding islands, ecotourism site selection, virtual travel, geotagging, highway planning, like that. Then first one is personality atlas. Assigning personality stereotype to countries around the world based on the sample size of global population preservatives. Then the tourist map. Plotting out landmarks in tourist maps. GIS has also been instrumental in plotting out maps for various locations across the globe. This way, tourists are able to find their way into various locations. Then the sunrise and sunset. Finding the perfect sunrise and sunset during at any given location using GIS. Tourists are able to locate the perfect sunrise and sunset and capture the best moments using this technology. Then subway map. Simplifying maps for the reader to better understand, such as the line of subway map in high contrasting colors. Travel mode detection. For detecting travel mode from a multimodal transportation network using GIS and GPS. Finding islands using satellite to find uninhabited island around the world. Ecotourism site selection. Gauging environmental impact for sustainable ecotourism sites. GIS can also help in gauging the impact of environmental occurrence. Then virtual travel, seeing your destination before physically being there through virtual travel. Tourists are also able to view their destination and see how it looks before actually getting to the destination. Next one is geotagging. Discover places with a 360 panoramic camera view. Then highway planning. Constructing viewpoint with multiple layers like ecology, topography and cultural features for a three-dimensional visual highway. Then the application of GIS on the side of tourist demand. Traveling to foreign countries, meeting new locations, travel planning, determination optimal location for a visit and accommodation, etc., impose the necessity of the usage of GIS by tourists. Time of GIS usage by the tourist demand is related to the period before and during the tourist trip. The main aspect of the GIS used by the tourist demand are related to search of tourist resources. Second one, assistance in making decision about a travel, then facilitating mobility in transit and tourist destination. Then we are move on to the specific key advantages of GIS for tourist. First one is visualization of tourist destination and place via maps. Then digital maps and video contents. Then valuable information about the tourist sites. Then the selective information and special activities such as road planning, accommodation information, cultural event, special attractions, etc. The most common use of GIS on the side of tourist demand is linked to the web GIS. Then, the role of GIS in protected areas. The development of information technology has received extraordinarily high importance in the field of biodiversity as well as the establishment and management of protected areas. The use of GIS is vital in terms of documenting information and the development of management model, not only at the local level but especially in large areas. Protection of natural resources has always benefited from the use of maps. For example, a map of species distribution of the reserve or a map of plant or animal communities. The purpose of the study was to perform mapping via GIS of locations for a sustainable development of paths in the protected area by overlapping layers, which shows the possibility for visitors and the carrying capacity of the area, taking into account all the components and interconnections of the tourist system. Then, this is the role of GIS in the analysis and management of cultural and historical heritage. GIS has multiple roles in the management of historical resources. Through more than two decades of work in archaeology, GIS technology has shown to be a powerful thing in locating, interpretation and preservation of historical sites. RadarSat, LandSat and images from the air over the vast region were important for locating previously unknown temples, cities and fortifications. The findings of many sacred places in Angkor and China were only possible through the use of radar images, which can detect changes in topography even in areas permanently covered by clouds. The discovery of the ancient roads, canals and irrigation systems using remote sensing data and expanded the knowledge about the development of human settlements. Then the advantages of GIS software in tourism sector. This allows the user to view, understand, query, interpret and visualize data in many ways. Also, updating and editing digital maps become easy as digitization techniques and GIS tools become popular. Only large organizations could afford to buy the GIS software required for this. With the advent of FOSS, free and open source software, GIS software was also available free of cost. Due to this, smaller organizations have also started using this technology. In this slide, how this GIS software worked on a tourism sector. we will discuss about it. Patterns, relationships and trends can be analyzed using digitized maps. Digitization of maps essentially involves demarcating, say, the coordinates around the monument, tourist attraction or hotel using GPS device. This device links the physical location via a satellite and returns the latitude and the longitude of the point on the earth's surface. Thus, the coordinates associated with the boundaries, that is, four points or corners around a specific spot, can be obtained. This is transferred into a digitized map along with the details such as places around the location, roads, buildings, landmarks, etc. Maps gain in value through acquisition of such data. Finally, different themes are added as layers, such as networks like roads, railway lines and waterways, points and polygons. The same process is used worldwide to solve problems applying GIS. Then we are move on to the methodological issues. GIS using recreation and tourism has been slow due to uncoordinated and ad hoc data collection procedures. Data derived from planning or policy making studies typically are collected at different times by different researchers for different purposes using different units of analysis and samples. Updating and maintaining data is most effective if incorporated into regular organizational procedures of the public agencies which hold relevant boundary and attribute information. In this scenario, information related to the tourism is very important for planning and development activities. Due to the development of information technologies, the marketing and attracting of foreign tourists also increased. GIS-based spatial decision support will support the tourist. The website-based tourism information will be useful to the foreign tourist for understanding the tourism spot and tourism information. GIS-based maps are useful to identify tourism spots with the facilities available in the location. Facilities like ATM, police station, tourism spots, etc. are important for tourists to easily navigate for their needs. GPS coordinates are useful to access the location with the help of navigation device. In tourism, the use of GIS is different on the side of the tourist offer and tourist demand. The side of tourist offer mainly uses all these aspects of the use of GIS. The side of tourist demand is actually using GIS technology that is installed by the tourist offer. It can be concluded that the side of the tourist offer is the provider and at the same time a user of GIS is a bidirectional one, while tourist demand appears as the one of the users as unidirectional one. Web-based GIS for managing and promoting tourism in sub-Saharan Africa. This is my first case study. Joseph Manco, Ebru Kolak and Ziang Li. These are the authors of the study. Next, we are move on to the aim of the study. First one is the propose a data flowing structure model for the management and sustainability of tourism based on resource setups. Then second one is the propose a model of tourism geo database and a repository for creating dynamic and interactive web maps which are coupled with the spatial analysis features to help tourists to explore more information. Finally, use the proposed geo database to design a web-based GIS model and use the web maps contained in the model to perform some spatial analysis to realize the model abstractions from its practical usability and its usefulness to tourists. Then This is the figure which will shows our requirements of WebGS model. In this figure, we will have three major sections. They are first one is administrator, second one web server, and users of information is the third one. In administrator part, this is simply the collection of information providers. They were provided different kinds of information. This information transferred into web server. So web server is the second section, and then it will be changed into the users friendly form. Here users of information is the third section. Then we are move on to the second methodology, physical implementation of the proposed model. Adopted the WebGIS architectural model to design web maps stored in the server side and the web page for browsing tourism information at the client side. In this WebGIS model system, these hosting institutions have the following tasks. First one is to identify and collect all spatial and non-spatial tourism data. Then to design and create a tourism geodatabase for handling tourism data. Then they were move on to design and create web maps and to design and create an interface that integrates web maps and other tourism based information. In order to realize the practical functionality of the model, they use Tanzania as the case study location to refer their data. Then identifying and designing tourism data flow management. This one is the third method. The proposed WebGIS model works with spatially georeferenced data. From the case study location, they identified three types of data for the successful management and promotion of tourism. These are tourist attraction, transport and accommodation facilities. They thematically classified these attractions into four groups. First one is wildlife areas that accounts 28% of the total land, that is national parks, game reserves areas and conservation areas. Then second one is marine park reserves. Then third one is historical and cultural heritage. And the last one is the infrastructures that include transport and accommodation. From these classified groups, they identified 11 specific data types with their administrating authorities to form a core structure for the management of tourism data. Next methodology is to designs for tourism geodatabase. Assembled vector or shape files and non-vector data which were digitized in GIS software through material guides from MNRT, that is Ministry of Natural Resource and Tourism in Tanzania. Then attributed data as pop-ups information on web maps were incorporated in feature classes by predefining data types such as text for textual information and raster for image or picture information. Due to the incapability of shape files to handle multimedia data when exported into cloud platforms, then another text fields were added to handle multimedia parts of the images hosted from other platforms like Dropbox. This is the table which will shows the list of the layers with attribute enabled to pop-ups the features. First one is the layer name, then enabled attributes are written here. First one is name, type, category, details, and universal resource locator. This is the figure which will shows the spatially based data flow model required by Tanzania Tourist Board for successful and sustainable management. In this figure, the data flow management structure provides power for Tanzania Tourist Board to link all tourism factors explained in requirements for the proposed WebGIS model. The data identified in figure 2 should be processed and organized into GIS database for visualization on maps. these are the different information providers, and this one is the cloud database. Then we are move on to the web map designs. Their goal is to have complete maps rendered on the World Wide Web by taking the advantages of both GIS and Internet. Therefore, the processing mechanisms applied in desktop GIS, where the view such a layout view in ArcGIS and a composer view in QGIS are used to communicate map contents. In web mapping, they adopted cloud computing techniques for enabling on-demand network access and visualization. Currently, there are many cloud computing platforms with different mapping capabilities such as Google, MapQuest, OpenLayer, Leaflet, etc. Some computing platforms such as Mapbox, CartoDB, MancoMap and GISCloud are project-based platforms which operate in different packages depending on feature customization. This study uses a community-free package from MancoMap for creating and designing web maps with query services. The web maps are customized with the standard color and symbols for easy preparations. This is the figure of a complete design of the GIS tourism database. Here, tourist entities, online base maps, shapefile layers are present. Aerodromes, animals, historical assets, climbing mountains, accommodation facilities, these are collected into or combined into a shapefile. Then roads as a separate shapefile, marine parks, wildlife reserves, water body, administration region as a another shapefile. These were put it into a tourism geodatabase, and also topographic map, satellite imagery, street maps. These were also collected into tourism geodatabase, and it will be worked. The last methodology is web-based GIS design for an interface. For that, to create an interface for accessing hosted information through browsers. For presenting tourism information via websites, they use the HTML provided to display of the hosted material with the hyperlink effects within Sublime Text 2 editor. Styles for enhancing structural visualization of the web elements were obtained by cascading style sheets as the de facto standard for HTML and JavaScript file. In this figure, the designed interface comprises three parts with different purposes, such as first one for accessing specific type of information, then for accessing web maps, and for communication and updates of the system. This figure presenting the coding environment for HTML, CSS and JavaScript in a Sublime Text 2 editor. Then these are the results and discussion. The web-based GIS is composed of three thematic parts as follows. The upper part providing access to view complement information for the dynamic and interactive web maps. Then second one is the middle part of furnishing access to dynamic and interactive web maps. The third one, the lower part displaying accessing of communication and regular updates by the promoting body. Then this is the tourism resource map of Tanzania. Here we have a legend with the historical heritages, airfields, marine park and reserves, accommodation services, international boundary, roads, water bodies, etc. The map had All attractions collected in the study except for the cultural zones present in the other web map. The attraction layer were set flexible for users to decide the choice, and they included widget tools to support navigation, by example zooming in or out, and to locate features through locational and information query search tool. This is the interactive tourism resource map. Then they used the legend widget tools, locational and information query search tool to interpret, understand and interactive with maps to explore more information as described in queries 1 to 6 below. First query, searching the accommodation facility with the criteria that the facility is within the wildlife area. This query returned 7 accommodation facilities on the map and their detailed information for either viewing, printing or shown its attribute table. Here these are the 7 accommodation facilities and these are the corresponding attribute information. Then move on to the query 2, searching regions with the wildlife national park. This query returned 24 regions, which are more than 70% of the total regions found in Tanzania, and attribute Tanzania. In query 3, searching for the World Heritage Sites. These are the spatial location results from the query 3. These are the heritage sites, World Heritage Sites present in Tanzania. And this is the query attribute information of query 3. Here mainly three World Heritage Sites are present. Then query 4, searching for airfields found within national parks. This query returned 12 airstrips locations with attribute truncated in table 4. This is the attribute information resulting from query 4. This is a query 5, looking for mountains with treks found within parks. This query returned 5 trekking mountains and their attributes are given below. This is the spatial location results from query 5 and corresponding attribute information is here. Then move on to the 6th query, looking for tourism attraction within marine parks and reserves. This query returned 6 marine sites and their attributes are shown in the table 6. This is the spatial location results from the query 6. The 6 sets of specific information were retrieved as a result of interaction by using web maps through queries. Such type of information cannot be achieved in static maps due to lack of interaction and too limited resources. They propose for the promoting body to share the information destined for the public users due to insecurity problems. These are the limitations of the study. To design web-based GIS is dependent on the practical usability of the hosting website. Therefore, it needs to be hosted for their model to display the web maps as the platform for promoting and accessing tourist information. Moreover, successful searching and retrieval depends only on the information contained in the model. The system from web maps cannot tell the hosting institution about the missing data. Therefore, in such circumstances, tourists will need to go back and use the access for communication to inform the hosting institution. The designed WebGIS has similar widget tool available in many popular GIS platforms such as MapStreet and Google Maps. Therefore, tourists can use such tools to navigate and search for the required information from base maps and thematic layers contained therein, which represents the user-friendly nature of the model. Lastly, our model or their model depends on the availability of internet for accessing information. When there is limited access to internet, it may fail to provide their requested information. Then, these are the conclusion part of their study. This study designed a specially based model for the management and promotion of tourism resource for sub-Saharan African countries. Tourism data are managed at the purposed geodatabase as a repository for creating dynamic and interactive web maps. In this model, geodatabase acts as the center for collecting and processing all tourism data, which then are delivered to tourists in the form of maps through cloud computing techniques. Results demonstrate that the design WebGIS model can successfully manage and promote the sustained tourism industry. Future studies should be directed towards implementing the designed model in different countries in the tourism industry. They should also focus to improve cloud web map servers to self-contain raster and video data attributes for automatic pop-ups display, and thus to ensure high security and reliability level of the independent system. Then we are move on to the second case study, Tourism Administration in Kerala, a GIS model for the 21st century, a pilot study by Venugopal CK, Assistant Professor of Kerala Institute of Tourism and Travel Studies. The main objectives of this study are to analyze the present state of use of GIS in Kerala tourism, and second one is to develop a sustainable model for the tourism administration by using GIS-based technologies. These are the methodologies. First one is research design, second one is pilot study, third one is present usage of GIS for tourism in Kerala, and fourth one is the literature review. First one is the research design. Primary data was collected using questionnaires and interviews. Then secondary data was collected from books, websites, journals, and also based on the literature available in brochures and promotional media. These are the research design methods. Then we are moving on to the pilot study. Data of tourists were collected from various tourist destinations in India, comprising both domestic and international. These were selected as pilot study. Then move on to the present usage of GIS for tourism in Kerala. Sites of Kerala IT Mission, Keltron and Department of Tourism provide GIS-based map, but not a fully fledged interface for administration. The official site of Matrubhumi, namely World Wide Web, Matrubhumi.com, provides a place finder tool in their travel section, which gives a feel close to the real thing. Through this, is restricted to route tracking and distance calculation. Then literature review, an important determinant of location of the study site is often the availability of reference material and image data. Then this is the diagrammatic representation of the proposed model. Here we have a data collection, data processing, and a data linkage from other departments. Data collection and data linkage from other departments, these were collected and it will be processed, then data updation, then central database engine. Here these layers were selected, and this data updation part is known as data acquisition, and this central database engine is known as GIS data server. And from where these are the linkages from Kerala Tourism website, and interface for queries and access to the cartographic information using the underlying GIS. These are the GIS layers. Then researchers, students, teachers, tourists, VSS, like that, agencies and the general public. These are the users group. Then decision making. This is the diagrammatic representation of the proposed model. Then we are moving to the study. Data was collected using questionnaires from administrators and managers and tourists. This was analyzed using statistical tools. The hypothesis framed is also follows. First one is the table of opinion survey based on the type of organization. This is used in tourism planning. Here we have the types of organizations: government, quasi government, NGO, private. And this is the total number. This is the strongly agreed one, and agreed and no option, disagree and strongly disagree, total. This is the opinion survey based on the type of organization. This is useful in tourism planning. This is the opinion survey based graphical representation. Here we get null hypothesis. There is no association between tourism planning and this, as evident from table 1. It can be inferred that there is a significant association between tourism planning and GIS. Hence, null hypothesis is rejected. It can be seen that NGOs, quasi government and private players use GIS for tourism planning more. This is the graphical representation. Here we have a private NGO and quasi government and government. Then table 2 shows the opinion survey based on type of organization. This is useful in tourism policy making. Here also types of organization and other strongly agree, no opinion, disagree and strongly disagree. Here we have corresponding chart. Here the opinion survey based on the type of organization. This is useful in tourism policy making. Here hypothesis 2 also null hypothesis. There is no significant association between tourism policy making and this, as evident from table 2. It can be inferred that there is a significant association between tourism policy making and this. Hence, null hypothesis is also rejected. NGOs, quasi government and private players use GIS for tourism policy making significantly. This is the third table. Here the opinion survey based on the type of organization. This is useful in tourism marketing. Here is the corresponding graphical representation of the table. GIS does not significantly contribute to tourism marketing, as evidence from the table 3. It can be inferred that GIS contributes significantly to marketing. Hence, null hypothesis is rejected. GIS is used in tourism marketing extensively by NGOs and quasi governments and private players. This is the worldwide cross tabulation of this is a must in tourism sector, and these are the results. In the case of Asia, there were 111 people were agree, and disagreeing is around 5. Corresponding to all other countries, the agreeing people, number of agreeing peoples were greater than the disagreeing one. The corresponding graphical representation is here. Here the red color line shows the agreeing one, and the blue color shows the non-agree or disagreeing one. These are the in the x-axis in Asia, Europe, Africa, North America and South America were marking, and corresponding respondents table is marked on the y-axis. Here we will show the here we will show the agreeing peoples are more than that of the disagreeing one. Then we are move on to the next table. Here we shows the cross tabulation between regions and the usefulness of GIS in itinerary planning. These are the findings of the study. GIS is used extensively worldwide for tourism planning, policy making and marketing. In the Indian scenario, and especially in Kerala, the application of GIS are minimal in government sector. It is evident that tourism administration can be made more effective and transparent by using a GIS-based model. Kerala will stand to benefit from this in the 21st century. These are the conclusions. The paper gives ample evidence to the importance of GIS in tourism administration. Using a GIS-based interface alone will not suffice in tourism administration. Developing a platform with an effective backend will go a long way in using GIS as an administrative tool in Kerala tourism. The study reveals that GIS is used in marketing, planning and some extent in policy making in private and quasi-government organizations. Hence, imbibing these success stories while implementing the model mentioned above go a long way in paving way to creating an dynamic and efficient model for tourism administration in the state of Kerala. These are the suggestions. This is yet to make any significant impact in tourism administration. Using the database management tools, a GIS-based model will help in decision making and policy formulation. Proposed GIS model for the 21st century. The proposed GIS model is being designed with the following objectives. First one is to map the resources related to tourism marketing. It will have tourism destination, hotels, other opinions like information about approved travel, tour operators, like etc. In tourism destination, based on unique value like hill stations, lakes, beaches, and based on category, and in the case of hotels, based on classification, and in the case of ecotourism, destinations of flora and fauna, trekking paths, wildlife sanctuaries and national parks, river and other water bodies in forest. In the case of travel, road maps and location, places and properties. Then second one is to provide reports based on empirical evidences for tourism planning and policy making. Then we are move on to the case study 3, tourist destinations in Slatibor and Slatter. This study was carried out in the tourist destination of Slatibor and Slatter, which have a lot of tourist resource facilities, products and offers. Some of the hotels in destination slightly more and slatter, and the most important tourist places were considered and transferred to the system. This is the map of tourist destination site of Slatibor and Slatter. Here we use the softwares like ArcGIS 9.1, ArcMap and ArcCatalog for this study. These are the methodologies, steps followed for establishing arrangement and density of tourist objects. These are the objects. Determination of tourist destination as raster map and creation of attribute data by tables. Then determination of important and necessary places for tourism. Then creation of thematic map. Then overlapping the layers of thematic maps. These are the methodologies they were used for this study. This is the Slatibor's raster map. This is the first step for the preparation of Slatibor's raster map. Then second one is the creation of attribute data, layers and attributes. The name of layers and the corresponding attributes are depicted here. Here the location, road, river, lake. Here we have the name, ID type, ID name, like that. Then next one is the determination of tourism place, destination boundaries and roads were demarcating. Then next one is the vector map. Here we have the destinations, like here we have the tourist hotels and restaurants demarcated here. Then step 4 for the creation of thematic maps. Here this figure will show the Slatibor and the Slatter tourist sub destination. Like here we have the lakes, visit sites and ski paths, like that. Here the corresponding tourist attractive areas of Slatter region 3A, 3B, 4A, 4B. These are the tourist attractive areas of Slatter region. These are the base map of the study area. Then last step is the overlapping the layers of thematic maps. First layer will have ski runs. Then second layer we have protected areas, and third layer protected areas with the ski runs. So these are the determination of the location for ski runs. Overlapping all the layers of thematic maps. This is the last method. These are the conclusions of the case study 3. Successful implementation of GIS promotes importance of information over technology. GIS has been successfully used in tourism for collecting, analyzing, modeling and visual presentation of tourist data. This is also used for bring the dereferenced data, that is spatial and non-spatial, of geographic location into digital maps. The integration of tourism data and GIS data is still a big challenge for the tourism industry today. Then these are the references. Thank you.